Hi everyone, Mike from CCTV Camera Pros here. In this video, I'm gonna test one of our Viewtron LPR cameras by mounting it at my house and setting the license plate recognition zone at kind of an extreme angle that I wouldn't normally recommend anyone use. We've been selling our Viewtron license plate recognition cameras now for many years, and it's been tremendously successful. But one of the things with LPR cameras is there's some strict installation requirements where the camera should be mounted as low to the ground, even with the license plate detection zone, as possible, and then not too much of a vertical or horizontal angle from the LPR detection zone. Well, honestly, we have a lot of homeowners that contact us that want to install an LPR camera on their house, similar to how I temporarily installed that one behind me. And me and the team have been telling people for years, no, you can't do this because it's way too much of an angle. Houses are set up, are set back too far from the road. You're gonna have to mount it too high and it just doesn't work, which has been the case up until now. Well, our new LPR IP4 model, that's a 4-megapixel LPR camera, has a bigger lens than our existing LPR IP7. It's an 8 to 32 millimeter lens, which lets you zoom in a lot more. So anyways, I set out to do this video to show people actually what not to do and that how LPR does not work well when installed on a house, but I was really surprised. It worked great. So a couple things. That camera is mounted 9 feet 4 inches off the ground, and my house is set back exactly 30 feet from the road in front of it. Now, my house is not exactly perpendicular. This road curves around a little bit. You could see the curve there. So I'm not exactly perpendicular to the road like most houses are, but the angle is not that great either. So what I did was, I angled the camera as much as possible down the street to minimize the LPR detection zone angle as much as possible. So I angled it as far as I could and then zoomed into a reasonable license plate detection zone. This license plate detection zone happens to be 110 feet away from where the camera is mounted, which is outside the detection zone that we typically recommend. So another variable that I didn't think would bode well for license plate recognition. Anyways, I'm gonna go upstairs on the recorder and play back some license plate recognition events for you, both for daytime LPR and nighttime LPR. And I think, like myself, you're gonna be very surprised. Here's the live view on the Viewtron NVR that the LPR camera and my other IP cameras are connected to. This is the Viewtron LPR camera right here. So I want to search for all the license plate recognition events. I do that by selecting Intelligent Analytics from this menu on the left. And then on the Intelligent Analytics screen, I'm going to select Vehicle. I'll leave the date as today. And I only want to search the Viewtron LPR camera for events, so I'll select that. And then the type of event is plate detection and license plate recognition. When I'm done, I click on this search button. And now it's querying the database for all the license plate detection and license plate recognition events. So it shows a thumbnail image of the plates that were captured, and then you'll see down below the number plate recognition. So if I check off one of these events and select playback, that'll start the video surveillance recording at that moment in time. And I'll zoom into the license plate here, and you can see it's crystal clear. So when I'm done, I'm gonna click exit and I'll go back to the event search screen again. And I wanna pull up an event now that was when it was dark out. So I'll go to like very early this morning when before the sun was up, and I'll select one of the nighttime license plate recognition events by checking the box on the thumbnail and then selecting playback again. Went a little too far there, so I'm going to back that up. You could use these video controls down here, obviously, to go in forward and reverse and then speed up the video. So I'll pause it again and zoom in. You could see that the nighttime license plate recognition is even better than the daytime. That is crystal clear. Another thing I just want to show you is when you have the playback screen open, you can jump to any of the license plate recognition events by using this timeline over here. The license plate recognition events are annotated in that like light aqua blue color. So I'll just pull up one more here and pause it again and zoom in on the plate. And you could see another excellent nighttime license plate recognition event captured right there. When I'm done, I can exit out of the video playback screen down here, and I'll close that search screen, and I'm back at the live view of the LPR camera, and we'll go back to that six camera view that we started at. Here's the live view of my home system. Guys, I hope this video has been helpful. CCTV Camera Pros has been supplying our Viewtron LPR camera solutions for commercial applications, business owners, and governments for many years. And me, James, Carlos, and Greg, we've been deterring homeowners from our Viewtron LPR camera and LPR cameras in general because they generally don't work at extreme angles like the one I just tested here. Well, I think we're gonna have to rethink this a little bit and update our recommendations, because this clearly shows that the Viewtron LPR IP4 can work fine when installed on a house like this. Now, I don't know if it'll work as well if the road in front of my house didn't have that little bit of curve. It's not gonna work as well if your house is exactly perpendicular, but at the same time, the curve is not that great, and the license plate detection zone I set up there starts before the road really starts curving a lot. So anyways, if you want to see additional videos, and I'm going to have more photos of this test that I did on the website, and we have a whole bunch of other videos of our Viewtron LPR system, you can go to www.cctvcamerapros.com/LPR. If you ever want to reach out to me for questions directly, you can email me direct at mike@cctvcamerapros.net. Thank you for watching.